Hello, everybody. Welcome to the series of lectures of epidemiology. And this is lecture one. The introduction to the fundamentals of epidemiology. What's the definition of epidemiology? It's constituted of three parts: epi, demos, logos. These are Greek words meaning on or upon. Demos means people, and logos means the study of. Definition is the study of the distribution and determinants of disease frequency in human populations. So, the study of the distribution and determinants of health-related states or events in specified populations and the application of this study to the control of health problems. This is the most commonly used definition. Epidemiology is concerned with who gets the disease and why. Epidemiologists study sick and well people to identify the existing differences between those who get disease and those who do not get the disease, despite that they are also exposed. Who is an epidemiologist? A professional who works to study and control the factors that influence the occurrence of disease or health-related conditions and events in specified populations and societies, has an experience in population thinking, epidemiologic methods, and public health, and also causal inference in health. What an epidemiologist needs to know? He needs to know about public health, clinical medicine, pathophysiology of the disease, how the disease develops, biostatistics, because we should do certain frequencies and statistics, social sciences, and ecology, which is the science of environment. The uses of epidemiology: identifying the causes of disease. By using epidemiological methods, we can identify a cause of a certain disease or identify as a new syndrome. We can complete the clinical picture of a disease. We can prevent and control disease in populations. We can assist in the management and care of health and disease in individuals. We can determine effectiveness of therapeutic and preventive measures, for example, mammograms or performing clinical trials. We can help and enhance understanding of what causes or sustains disease in populations. We can guide the policy and planning of health and healthcare. We can help decision makers to implement plans and take actions. We can monitor the health of a community, region, or nation by surveillance or certain reports like accident reports. We can identify risks in terms of probability statements, such as studying risk factors. We can study trends over time to make predictions for the future. For example, the relationship between smoking and lung cancer, or estimating the health services needs. We can study the cause or etiology of disease or conditions, disorders, disabilities, etc. Determine the primary agent responsible or ascertain the causative factors for the disease. Determine the characteristics of the agent or causative factors. Define the mode of transmission of the disease, how the disease is transmitted from one person to another. Determine contributing factors. There are some factors that contribute to the process of disease development. Identify and determine geographic patterns because disease is distributed by geography. Epidemiology as a science. It's particularly relevant to medicine rather than laboratory science, but we use the work of laboratory when we are applying our epidemiology. Epidemiology is concerned with disease in populations, while medicine is concerned with disease in individuals. Humans live in societies where behavior and attitudes are formulated by interaction among people, which in turn are governed by the regulations and laws. Epidemiology is therefore not only a bioscience, but also a social science, because sociology integrates the response between individuals, taking into consideration the behaviors among different people. Populations are exposed to physical environment, which is a dominant force in determining health. The study of life in relation to the environment is ecology. So epidemiology is, in addition, the science of the ecology of disease. The science of epidemiology, therefore, combines elements of biology, social sciences, and ecology, a biosocial environmental science focusing on disease in populations. What are the core epidemiologic functions? First, public health surveillance. It's defined as the ongoing systemic collection, analysis, interpretation, and dissemination of health data to help guide public health decision making and action. Field investigation. The science of epidemiology is usually based on field visits. We used to go to the field and find the what we need there in the field. Analytic studies. We need to conduct certain studies of analytical nature that involves attempts to make a correlation or causative relation between an exposure and disease. Evaluation, the process of determining the relevance, effectiveness, efficiency, and impact of activities with respect to established goals. Linkages. We conduct epidemiological studies in a multidisciplinary team. So the process of epidemiological investigations involve different specialties where a doctor is needed, an epidemiologist is needed, a lab technician is needed, and also a statistician is needed. So it is multidisciplinary. The work of epidemiologists provide regular input and recommendation regarding disease control strategies, reportable disease regulations, and healthcare policy. So also epidemiology is concerned with policy development. Epidemiology can address these variables: disease, which is morbidity, death, mortality, hospitalization, number of people that get into the hospital, disability, quality of life, and health status. What are the broad types of epidemiology? We have two types of epidemiology: descriptive epidemiology, which examines the distribution of a disease in a population and observe the basic features of its distribution in terms of time, place, and person. We try to formulate hypotheses and look into associations. A typical study design for descriptive epidemiology is a cross-sectional study. The other type is analytic epidemiology. We test for a specific hypothesis about the relationship of a disease to a specific cause by conducting an epidemiologic study that relates the exposure of interest to the outcome of interest, cause-effect relationship. A typical study design is a cohort or case control or experimental design. To perform analytic epidemiology, we need definitely to have information about descriptive epidemiology. What's the basic triad of descriptive epidemiology? We have three essential characteristics of disease we look for in descriptive epidemiology: person, place, and time. Regarding person, the personal characteristics, also called demographics, and the acronym WHO, who get the disease. We need to know the age, because disease differ by age, gender, also there are differences in disease occurrence by gender, socioeconomic status, education, occupation, income also affect the incidence of disease, marital status, ethnicity, race, and genetic profile also affect the occurrence of disease, and certain people are more liable to have disease by race or ethnic group. The presence of concurrent disease also affect the occurrence of other diseases. Habits: dietary habits, exercise, smoking also affect the occurrence of disease, especially chronic diseases, and the risk-taking behavior. Place: we answer the question where the disease occurs. Either the disease is geographically restricted or widespread, an outbreak, epidemic, or a pandemic. Climate factors like temperature, humidity, and combined effects from these physical factors play a role in occurrence of diseases. The area: urban, suburban or rural areas. There are differences in disease occurrence among these sectors. Relation to environmental exposure, whether water or food supply affect the occurrence of disease. Geology, the study of environment. Environment affect the disease occurrence. Population density. If more people reside in certain area, the likelihood of certain diseases is higher. The economic development also affect the occurrence of disease because it is concerned with good hygiene or bad hygiene, good antiseptic or the absence of antiseptics. Several factors play a role here. Nutritional practices also are related to disease occurrence. For example, unhealthy diet lead to the development of non-communicable diseases, cardiovascular diseases particularly. Medical practices and the presence of or agents or vectors. Agents or vectors are essential for infectious diseases to occur. Now we come to the question, when the disease occurs. At what date and exact time the event occurs? Is it changing or stable? Is it clustered, an epidemic, or evenly distributed, an endemic disease? Is it a point source or propagated that make waves? Or seasonal, come in a certain season, or a combination of all these. So time trends, either we use the exact time, the calendar time, or we have cyclic diseases occur in cycles, or the disease is seasonal, occurs in certain seasons. And also we have temporal trends. And secular trends. For temporal trends, these are the trends of diseases that recur in a certain short time. But a secular trend is a disease that occur for a long time and take decades. So epidemiology weighs and balances, epidemiology contrasts and compares epidemiology use rates. The numerator. It's the number of people to whom something happened. Who got sick or who died. The denominator, the population at risk. All the people at risk of the event and can have the disease. Types of epidemiology. Descriptive epidemiology and analytic epidemiology. In descriptive epidemiology, we gather information. These are descriptive information only. But in analytic epidemiology, we test for hypotheses and try to find a cause, a risk factor cause relationship. What's the disease triad? Host, agent, and environment. This is the epidemiological homeostasis. when these three elements are synchronized and balanced, the situation will be good and the rate of diseases will be as low as possible. When there is disturbance in these factors, diseases occur. So what are the host factors? Personal traits, behaviors, genetic predisposition, immunologic factors, people with low immunity. All these influence the chance for disease or its severity. When it comes to agents, we have biological, physical, and chemical agents. These agents can lead to a certain disease. When it comes to environment, external conditions, physical or biological or social environment can contribute to the disease process. So epidemics arise when host, agent, and environmental factors are not in balance due to a new agent that occurs. For example, COVID-19, it's a new, totally new agent, or due to change in existing agent. And in the existing agent increased in infectivity, became more infective, or more pathogenic, or more virulent, or due to change in number of susceptibles in the population. For example, if the population is of older age, the susceptible people are higher in number. Due to environmental changes that affect transmission of the agent or growth of the agent. Thank you very much.